大家好，我是 Eddie。Hi guys, this is Eddie. Welcome to the HSK series. Today's material is from HSK Level 4 Textbook, Lesson 11. Let's get started. 我们开始吧。Lesson 11, 第十一课，读书好，读好书，好读书。It's good to read. Read good books and like reading. You might notice that we have the same character, 好, in the three phrases, but each phrase has a different meaning.Because of the order of 好, this character. For example, number one, 读书好, that means it's good to read. That means to read book is a good thing. So you can change 读书 with some other phrasal verbs. For example, you can say 运动好, because 运动is to do sports. And if you say 运动好, it's good to do sports. Number two, 读好书, read good books. Here, 好 works as an adjective. 好书, good books. What if you say 坏书, 坏 literally means bad. If you say 坏书, that means bad books. 读好书, to read good books. Phrase number three, 好读书. You notice here the tone is the fourth tone because 好, this character, is a polyphone. In this very context, it means to like to do something. We know the normal way to say like in Chinese is 喜欢, 喜欢. So the alternative way to say to like reading is 喜欢读书, but here 好读书 has the same meaning. It just sounds a little bit formal, more formal and more written way. 热身, warm up, 给下面的词语选择对应的图片。并用这个词语根据图片说一个句子。给下面的词语选择对应的图片，并用这个词语根据图片说一个句子。
Match the pictures with the words and describe the pictures with sentences using the words.
一，客厅，客厅。Living room. 二, 猜, 猜,
guess.
复杂, 复杂,
complicated.
阅读, 阅读,
to read or reading.
杂志, 杂志,
magazines.
笔记，笔记。
Notes.
Answers. 答案。
Picture A. 杂志。Picture B.
阅读。
Picture C.
猜。
Picture D.
客厅。
Picture E.
复杂
Picture F
笔记二读一读下面的句子说一说这些句子有哪些特点读一读下面的句子说一说这些句子有哪些特点
Read the following sentences and talk about their characteristics.
一，别着急，马克正开着车，他马上
就到。别着急，马克正开着车，他马上就到。
Don't worry, Mark is driving the car. He will be here right away.
别着急 means don't worry. 别 means don't. 着急
literally means worry.
马克
that is the translation of the name Mark, because Mark sounds like 马克
马克 Mark.
正 that's a signal word for be doing.Which means present continuous tense in Chinese language.
开 means to drive. 车 means a car. 正开着车 is driving a car.
The character after 开 pronounces as 着. 着 is a signal word for current state or status. For example, you can say 吃着饭。If you say 吃着饭, that's is eating or be eating, because 着 signals the status or signal the current state of somebody eating something.
他 means he, 马上 means immediately or right away, 就 means something is about to happen, 到 means to arrive or to reach.
就到 is about to get here or is about to arrive here. For example, you can say 就来 is about to come because 来 literally means come.
二小朋友我们一起数数字学数数
小朋友我们一起数数字学数数 Little kid, let's count numbers and learn how to count numbers together.
小朋友
little kid, 小 little, small.
朋友
friend,
我们
we as a pronoun.
一起
Be careful with the sound of E, that's fourth tone, which means this character is a polyphone.
一起
means together.
数数字
literally is to count numbers.
数
is a verb to count.
数字
is a noun, number, count numbers. You notice that
数
is a polyphone.The first one is 数 with the third tone. The second one is fourth tone.
数数字学数数
学 means to learn, to study.
数
here is a verb again, means to count.
数
that means number. So 学数数 literally the three characters means to learn, to study, count,numbers.
小朋友我们一起数数字学数数。三他要求自己每次都得把汉字写得特别好看。他要求自己每次都得把汉字写得特别好看。
He requests or he demands himself to write Chinese characters extraordinarily well every time.
他
is a pronoun, he.
要求
is a verb, to demand or to request.
自己
that means self, and here it means himself.
每次
every time
每
is every
次
means time
都
that means all or both and here obviously 都 means every time and then it stands for
or, not both. Day, this word is a polyphone. In this sentence, day, this character appears twice. This is the first time. Pronounce it as day. Day means have to do something. Ba is a signal word of a very important grammar. Ba signals the action giver. So the subject before ba stands for an action giver. And the action giver of this sentence is he, because he as a person, as a human being, he will write characters. So he is the action giver to write characters. 汉字 means Chinese characters. 写 means to write. 德 here pronounces as 德, not day. The first time it shows in the sentence pronounces as day, but here it's 德. And 德 doesn't really have a particular meaning. It is just a grammar point marker. In Chinese language, if you want to use an adverb or use a phrase to describe a verb, the grammar structure is verb plus 德, this character, and then plus adverb or plus a descriptive phrase. Here, 写得特别好看 means to write extraordinarily well, because 特别 means particularly, extraordinarily, or especially. 好看 means well, but literally 好 is good, and 看 is to look. So 好看 kind of is like good looking. To review the use of 德, this character, you can say, for example, 吃得快, 吃得快. 吃 means to eat. 德 doesn't have a meaning, it's just a grammar marker. 快 is an adverb, and it describes how you eat your meal. You eat very fast, that's why you say 快, standing for fast or quickly. 吃得快 means to eat fast. 4等你长高了这条牛仔裤穿起来就不长了等你长高了这条牛仔裤穿起来就不长了。After you become taller, this pair of jeans will no longer be too long. 等 means to wait. 你 pronoun means you. 长 means to grow. 高 means height. Literally, 长高 means to grow height. 乐 usually it's a signal word for past tense or present perfect tense. However, sometimes you can also use it in the future tense. So 长高了 means will grow height, or you can just say becoming taller. 这条 means this pair of. 这 means this. 条 literally means pair, this pair. 牛仔裤 together means jeans. 牛仔 actually means cowboy. 裤 literally means pants or trousers in British English. 穿 means to wear. However, 穿起来, I suggest you not break down word by word because it doesn't make much sense. 穿起来, just treat these three characters meaning wear. In English, we have perception verbs. What are perception verbs? That means it stands for your feelings, like sounds, or feel, or look, or smells, or tastes. All these verbs are considered verbs of perception. So here, in Chinese, we also have very similar concepts. If you say 穿起来, it works as a perception verb. However, in English, it doesn't work as a perception verb. To help with your understanding of the Chinese version of perception verbs, I will give you other examples. How do we say sounds? For example, you sound good, that kind of sounds in Chinese. We say 听起来, 听起来, which literally means sounds in English. And if you say 看起来, 看起来, that means looks. For example, she looks beautiful, and then you can say 看起来. If you want to say tastes, you can say 尝起来, 尝起来. Last but not least, if you want to say smells, as in the room smells bad, you can say 闻起来, 闻起来. And I hope that explains your confusion with 穿起来. 穿起来 means wear. 就, this character works as is about to or will. If you look at sentence 1, you will also see 就, this character, meaning will or be about to. 不长, 不 means no or not. 长 means long. So here, 不长 means not long. 就不长, these three characters means won't be long. 了, again, it could be a past tense signal word, but also here it appears in the future tense structure. Because you can treat 就了as a fixed grammar point, which means will be blah blah. So 就不长了, you can translate it as will not be long anymore.
五, 你帮我把那个没把的杯子拿过来。你帮我把那个没把的杯子拿过来。你帮我把那个没把的杯子拿过来。
Please help me to bring that cup without a handle here.
你 means you. 帮 means to help. 我 means I or me. Here it works as me. 把
again, I told you it means an action giver. So you is the action giver.
那个
means that. 没 means no or not.
Bar
is such a northern way or like a Beijing way to say it. Bar means a handle, like a handle on a cup or on a mug. Again, ba, it's a polyphone. Here it reads as the fourth tone. Ba, ba, reads as father because we say father as ba ba, that sound of ba. However, usually we pronounce this character as ba, ba, because when you read it as ba, it works as an action giver. R, this word is with the second tone, R. However, R doesn't mean a son here because R could be a son, S-O-N, son. But here, it's just like the habit of people from northern China or people from Beijing. They like to say R at the end of their phrase. For example, if they want to say here, they would say 这儿, 这儿, and they read it extremely fast, it will become 这儿, 这儿, 这儿. If they say there, they would say 那儿, and in a faster way, it would be 那儿, 那儿, 那儿. For me, I'm from south. I will never say that. I say 这里, 这里 means here, and 那里, 那里 means there. 的 is an adjective signal word or possessive signal word. 杯子 could be a glass or a cup. But here it's definitely a cup because they're talking about the handles. And usually a glass is without a handle. And if you say 没把的杯子, this characters, all the characters together, meaning a cup or a mug without a handle. 拿 means to bring. 过来 means here. 拿过来 means bring here. 课文一 Text 1. 马克介绍自己学习汉语的方法。Mark introduces his way to self-study Chinese Mandarin. 你来中国才一年，汉语就说得这么流利，真厉害。You only come to China for 1 year, and you can speak Chinese Mandarin so fluently. That's impressive.
谢谢。其实我的语法不太好，很多句子说的都不太准确。
Thank you. Actually, my grammar is not that good. A lot of sentences will not be spoken accurately.
但是我看你跟中国人交流没什么问题，你是怎么做到的？
But I noticed that you have no problem in communicating with Chinese. How did you make it?
平时多交一些中国朋友，经常和他们聊天，听说能力自然就能得到很大的提高。
In daily life, make more Chinese friends. Often chat with them. The ability of listening and speaking will be improved drastically.
另外，我建议你坚持看中文报纸，这样能学到很多新词语。
Besides, I suggest you insist on reading Chinese news. In this way, you can learn a lot new words.
你太厉害了，连中文报纸都看得懂。
You are so impressive. You can even read Chinese newspaper.
刚开始肯定有困难，不过遇到不认识的词语，你可以查词典，然后写在本子上，有空就拿出来复习一下，慢慢的就会发现中文报纸也没那么难了。
At the beginning, you definitely will encounter difficulty. However, when you meet new words, you can look it up in the dictionary. Then you can write them on your notebook. When you have time, just take the notes out and try to review. And slowly, you will realize reading Chinese newspaper is not that tough.
Second time.Standard reading.
第二遍常速阅读。你来中国才一年，汉语就说得这么流利，真厉害。 谢谢。其实我的语法不太好，很多句子说得都不太准确。但是我看你跟中国人交流没什么问题。你是怎么做到的？平时多交一些中国朋友， 经常和他们聊天，听说能力自然就能得到很大的提高。另外，我建议你坚持看中文报纸，这样能学到很多新词语。你太厉害了，连中文报纸都看得懂。刚开始肯定有困难，不过遇到不认识的词语，你可以查词典，然后写在本子上，有空就拿出来复习一下，慢慢的就会发现中文报纸也没那么难了。生词 New words 一，流利，流利。二，厉害，厉害，厉害。三，语法，语法。四，准确，准确，准确。五，词语，词语，词语。六，连，连。专有名词 proper nouns。 大卫，大卫 David。
Can't get enough of what you heard? Simply subscribe Eddie's channel and stay tuned for the next update. 好了，今天的内容就到这里结束了，我们下次见，拜拜。